May you never take one single breath for granted. God forbid love ever leave you empty-handed. I hope you still feel small when you stand beside the ocean. Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith the fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance. I hope you dance. I hope you never fear those mountains in the distance. Never settle for the path of least resistance. Living might mean taking chances, but they're worth taking. Loving might be a mistake, but it's worth making. Don't let some hell-bent heart leave you bitter. When you come close to selling out, reconsider. Give the heavens above more than just a passing. When you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you do. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance.
Well, as you've already heard, and as you know, if you knew Casey, she was full of life. In many ways, she was larger than life. Everywhere she went, when she entered a room, she lighted up that room. Just the way she was, that big smile that she had, she was a ray of light. She had that infectious smile, that sense of humor that lifted the spirits of everyone around her. She was one that I never met a stranger. I remember the first time I met her and when I was around her at church, just one that could walk up to anyone and begin a conversation with them. She was always doing for others. Perhaps that's something that sticks out to many of you. She was always looking out for others' needs, for others' concerns. There was a story that when she was 8 years old, she was in a severe car accident. And she was in the hospital for 28 days. And during that time, the family members were all concerned about her and her condition. And she was busy comforting them, telling them that she was going to be okay. She was spontaneous. That's a word that that described her. One of the more humorous stories I heard was that her aunt was planning her 50th birthday, an Hawaiian party. And Casey was going to get married, and so she just decided to have her wedding along with the 50th anniversary Hawaiian birthday party. It's an unusual combination. I've done weddings, but I've never done one in combination with a birthday party. I guess she thought that would be more efficient and just take care. You know, there's already going to be a party. Why not be a part of that party, right? I mean, she was one that kind of brought the party with her. And so I don't know that she asked permission. I think she just more or less, the way I understand the story, was stated, this is what we're going to do. And so they had the wedding in the front yard and the Hawaiian birthday party in the backyard. Interesting combination. But those of you that know her know that just fits her. That story describes her perfectly. Her friends just talk about her, and I read some of the things online, and they were consistent about some of the things that y'all wrote in about her. I've talked to more than one person. I've talked to her mother and other friends that would say they would just get a phone call in the middle of the day, and the first statement would be, "Just pray for me. Just pray for me." And they knew that it was that something was going on in her life, and she needed to talk to somebody. Just kind of, I guess, talk it out. And she wanted someone to pray for. She loved her family, and her life was really centered around her family, particularly her children and all the activities that they were involved in. It wasn't really about her; it was about others. It was about her family. She loved being around her family. She talked about her grandmother and the fried chicken that her grandmother made, and how much she loved that. I don't think Jeff liked, I understand you weren't a chicken eater, but she was. You were from California, I guess they eat other strange things out there. Jeff shared the story of when he met her. You know, Jeff was an EMT, and Casey had come to work there, and Jeff was being part of the fraternity, you know, felt like that he needed to haze her, I guess, the first day, and was giving her a hard time. And he said he was very ugly to her. And he said, that's the way they treated me, so I thought that was the way that I was supposed to treat, all the rookies on the shift. And he said, though, by the end of the shift, quote, he was enamored by her. That was how quickly, how warm her personality was, how infectious it was, and indeed, Jeff was infected by it. And started dating her, and then 8 months later, married her. Not the way to meet a woman, by being ugly, but she was able to overcome that. Again, her life revolved around her kids. I was asking about hobbies and so forth, and they said, well, her hobbies were taking her kids and being around family. She enjoyed horseback riding and other things, but basically it was about family. You know, she always wanted to work in the medical field, and was derailed from that several times, and though her life ended working in that field, I don't know that she would have wanted it any other way. Life was not always easy for Casey. There were many ups and downs throughout her life, but she was always able to overcome them, to keep going, to keep getting up and plowing along. You know, regardless of what some TV preachers may tell you, God does not promise that life will be good or easy or even fair. It's not a matter of knowing the right scripture or claiming the right scripture. Sometimes life is just very difficult. And again, it was not easy and certainly not fair for Casey. Some of us would look at her death, her tragic death, or the accidental death and say it was most unfair. What lessons can we learn from her life and even her death? And what comfort, is there some comfort that we can take from this story? Well, one of the principal lessons that we all can learn from this is that life can end at any moment. It can end suddenly. It can end at any moment. And many of you, the fields you work in, you're exposed to that. You may be busy saving lives, but your own life may come into danger at any given moment. And we better be ready. We better be ready for what lies ahead. What comfort can we take from this? For those of us that have a relationship with Jesus Christ can take comfort through these events. You see, as Christians, we understand that we live as foreigners, as aliens in this world, that it is our temporary home. As Carrie Underwood sings, this is our temporary home. It's not where we belong. Windows and rooms that we're passing through. This is just a stop on the way to where we're going. I'm not afraid because I know this is our temporary home. In the book of Hebrews, there is a list of many of the great saints that lived in the Old Testament. Such names as Abel and Enoch, Noah, Abraham, even a prostitute, Rahab, Gideon, Barak, Samson, Jephthah, David, Daniel, Samuel, and other prophets. In Hebrews 11:13, it reads, all these people were still living by faith when they died. They did not receive the things promised. They only saw them and welcomed them from a distance. And when they admitted that they were aliens and strangers on this earth. People who say such things show that they are looking for a country of their own. If they had been thinking of the country they had left, they would have had opportunity to return. Instead, they were longing for a better country, a heavenly one. Therefore, God is not ashamed to be called their God, for he has prepared a city for them. In John's gospel, John gives us words of great comfort. John chapter 14 reads, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And where I go, you go. And, curious phrase, and the way you know. And then Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going, and how can we know the way? And Jesus said, I am the way, the truth,